In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Dear brother in Christ Jesus, both the first reading and the gospel tell us that God's promises that were granted, promised to our forefathers in the Old Testament still holds good. God always invites each one of us to reach Him, to share His glory as He experiences, as He dwells with His Father. The same glory Jesus promises to each one of us whose sins are forgiven on this earth, at the same time who has a real faith in Him that He is the Savior for each one of us. To celebrate this Eucharist in a worthy way, let us recall to mind the sins and failures, and let us ask God's pardon and forgiveness. I confess
to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my faults, through my most grievous faults. Therefore I ask, Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and to you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Clothe us, O Lord God, with the virtues of the heart of your Son, and set us aflame with his love, that conformed to his image, we may merit your share in eternal redemption, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns within the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen.
We must therefore do everything we can to reach this place of rest. First reading, a reading from the letter to the Hebrews, chapter 4, verses 1 to 5 and 11. First reading, a reading from the letter to the Hebrews, chapter 4, verses 1 to 5 and 11. Be careful the promise of reaching the place of rest God had for the Israelites still holds good, and none of you must think that he has come too late for it. We received the good news exactly as they did, but hearing the message did them no good because they did not share the faith of those who listened. We, however, who have faith, shall reach a place of rest, as in the text. And so, in anger, I swore that not one would reach the place of rest I had for them. God's work was undoubtedly all finished at the beginning of the world. As one text says, referring to the seventh day, after all, his work God rested on the seventh day. The text we are considering says, they shall not reach the place of rest I had for them. We must therefore do everything we can to reach this place of rest, or some of you might copy this example of disobedience and be lost. This is the word of the Lord. Your response to the psalm, never forget the deeds of the Lord. The things we have heard and understood, the things our fathers have told us, we will not hide from their children, but will tell them to the next generation the glories of the Lord and His might and the marvelous deeds He has done. Your response? They too should arise and tell their souls, sons, and they too should set their hope in God and never forget God's deeds, but keep every one of His commands. Your response?
Never forget the deeds of the Lord.
So that they might not be like their fathers, a defiant and rebellious race, a race whose heart was fickle, whose spirit was unfaithful to God. Your response?
Never forget the deeds of the Lord.
Please stand for the gospel acclamation. After me,
a great prophet
has appeared among us. God has visited his people.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Saint Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Second chapter of Saint Mark, verses 1 to 12. When Jesus returned to Capernaum, word went round that he was back. And so many people collected there, and that there was no room left, even in front of the door. He was preaching the word to them when some people came bringing him a paralytic carried by four men. But as the crowd made it impossible to get the man to him, they stripped to the roof over the place where Jesus was. And when they had made an opening, they lowered the stretcher on which the paralytic lay. Seeing their faith, Jesus said to the paralytic, "My child, your sins are forgiven." Now some scribes were sitting there, and they thought to themselves, "How can this man talk like that? He is blaspheming. Who can forgive sins but God?" Jesus, inwardly aware that this was what they were thinking, said to them, "Why do you have these thoughts in your hearts? Which of these is easier, to say to the paralytic, 'Your sins are forgiven,' or to say, 'Get up, pick up your stretcher and walk'? But prove to you that the Son of Man has authority on earth to forgive sins." He said to the paralytic, "I order you, get up, pick up your stretcher and go off home." The man got up, picked up his treasure at once, and walked out in front of everyone, so that they were all astounded and praised God, saying, "We have never seen anything like this." This is the gospel of the Lord. Dear brother in Christ Jesus, today's first reading concludes like this in the letter to the Hebrews: "We must therefore do everything we can to reach the place of rest." Or some of you might copy this example of disobedience and be lost. There was a man who was driving an expensive car in the countryside, and he stopped in a parking place, and some of the wayward beggars, they stopped the vehicle and they asked him, "What is it? You are such an expensive car you are driving, but your windows at the rear side is broken." The man who was driving the vehicle, expensive car, he said, "Yes, I know. My car is an expensive one, but still my car's rear window is broken and I have not rectified. But remember, I have kept this one in order to remind me that God's love comes to me through this broken glass." "Then what is that?" they asked. "How do you think that God's love comes through this broken window?" Then he narrated an incident that took place while they were driving in the highway, and all of a sudden a stone hit this window screen, and immediately they stopped the car and went there to find out who threw this stone. There was a gentleman who was carrying the wounded, lame brother while he was crossing, and he was hit by, his lame brother was hit by a motorcyclist, and he went on calling for help to be taken to him to the hospital. Nobody stopped. So what he thought as a last resort, he took the stone and threw it, and immediately said, "Sir, with a folded hands, I am sorry. I did not have any other way. I could not understand what to do since my brother is suffering and he is bleeding. That's why I took the stone and threw it." And that time the gentleman was remembering God's love comes through anybody. This broken window was always reminding him, even though there were some misfortune, some problem, but God would be always benevolent to some people. And he started helping the boy and his brother, lame brother, who was wounded. This is exactly today we read in the gospel, and they were bringing down the paralytic man with a lot of faith, hoping that Jesus would be able to really save him and heal him. That, as you heard rightfully, the incident which we hear in the gospel is something good in the sense all of us can visualize what type of faith these people had, especially his companions, his friends. One thing we understand, if we have good friends, certainly good friends will guide us to walk along the good way which is designed by God himself. That is why among the faith seekers, among our community, you should have people who could motivate your faith rather than who would diffuse them
and throw them out. So look at the companions first. What type of companions that we have? Or is it only for the gossiping, talking about the third person? Or to nurture our faith? That is the one lesson we can learn today. The second thing I would like to reflect here is Jesus wanted by all means to tell this, the community of lawyers or the tax collectors, Pharisees, to say. Every time they were always thinking that sin was always linked to their diseases, especially this leprosy or paralytic crippled man, it was always thought by these people, taught by the people, because you might have made some mistake, you might have committed some mistake, or your parents might have done sins, and that is why now God punishes you. God is not the person who would punish, rather. God is the person who would always show his forgiveness to the person who asks for his mercy. And that is why he said, your sins are forgiven. Now, they thought Jesus was an ordinary man coming from the Nazareth, and how he could say that sins are forgiven, only God alone. And now once again, second lesson. Remember, when we come to God, like Pharisees, we need not just boast about what we have been doing. Never, because he knows. Now, though those people were thinking that how he could say that his sins are forgiven because only God alone could say that one. And perceiving their secret thoughts, and Jesus started questioning them, which means Jesus, for him today, tomorrow, yesterday, everything is same. He knows us. That's why he was able to understand their thinking, and he questioned them once again, which is easier, to forgive sins or to ask the man to get up and take the mat and walk? And finally he said, the Son of Man has power to do both. Because whenever we approach him, or whenever we seek the intercession of St. Anthony, what is happening? He makes the person whole. Whether it is a bodily ailment or spiritual ailment, or we have psychosomatic diseases, for everything God can make us whole, provided that we still trust him, believe him, and our faith is every day is increasing in such a way that we surrender to him. That's the second aspect. The last final aspect I would like to propose. Henceforth, dear friends, let us not be discouraged, because the promises that God has given to us in the past, in the Old Testament, to our ancestors, still holds good. Though some of us may be lagging behind, we may be not coming to Jesus Christ, closer to him, still God says, I affirm you that faith, because of your faith, you will receive. Your sins will be forgiven, and you will be restored to receive the eternal life. May we all today, as we pray, as we are going to offer the bread and wine, we shall bring our family members to the altar of God, asking the Lord to restore them. Restore them both physically and spiritually, so that all of us could form a living, good community in this world to reflect God's image in this world. Jesus was able to reflect God the Father's forgiveness and the mercy towards that crippled, paralytic man. Can we all show that type of understanding, sympathy, and empathy towards the people who are suffering among us. Amen.
Hymn number 205.
My sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Father Almighty.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice of your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church.
O God, Father of mercies, who because of the great love with which you loved us, with untold goodness gave us your only begotten Son, grant we pray that being perfectly united with him in faith, we may offer you worthy homage through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For raised up high on the cross, he gave himself up for us with a wonderful love, and poured out blood and water from his pierced side, the wellspring of the church sacrament, so that won over to the open heart of the Savior, all might draw water joyfully from the springs of salvation. And so with all the angels and saints, we praise you, as without end we acclaim.
Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Lord, we lift up your name with our hearts filled with praise. Be exalted, O Lord our God, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed, blessed, blessed is the King of God. Blessed, blessed, blessed is the one who comes. Lord, we lift up your name with our hearts filled with praise. Be exalted, O Lord our God. Blessed is the one who comes. Hosanna.
are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them, like the dew fall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time Jesus was betrayed and he entered willingly into his passion, Jesus took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, Jesus took the chalice and, once more giving thanks, he gave to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is a chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Jesus, name above all names, beautiful Savior.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, the Mabal, our Archbishop, and bishops and clergy everywhere. Remember your servants, Anthony Xavier, Raj and Jude, Mark Matthew, and his grandparents, Prabhakaretti, Anthony Xavier, J. Chinnamma, and other brothers and sisters whom we remember, who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them in the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, Saint Anthony of Padua, our patron saint, with all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coheirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, at your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity, in accordance with the will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that I should enter my roof. But only say the word,
and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ keep us safe for eternal life.
Amen.
Hymn number 357, 357.
Oh,
us, says the Lord. From within the one who believes in me. Let us pray. May partake us in your sacrament of charity. We humbly implore your mercy, Lord, that we may be conformed to Christ on earth and merit to be co-heirs of his glory in heaven, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless us, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God. Thank you, O Lord, your love is boundless. Thank you, your presence is our peace. Thank you, O Lord, for so much goodness. Thank you, your mercies never cease. Thank you, O Lord, your love is boundless. Thank you, your presence is our peace. Thank you, O Lord, for so much goodness. Thank you, your mercy never cease. Thank you, we heard your word this morning. Thank you, we ate the bread of life. Thank you for sending us your spirit. Thank you for giving us your peace. Thank you, O Lord, your love is boundless. Thank you, your presence is our peace. Thank you, O Lord, for so much goodness. Thank you, your mercy never cease. Thank you, your mercy.